118. My sins are gone. What a joy to know our sins are gone. You ask me why I'm happy, so I'll just tell you why. Because my sins are gone. And when I meet the scoffers who ask me where they are, I say, my sins are gone. Well, they're underneath the blood on the cross of Calvary, as far removed as darkness is from dawn. In the sea of God's forgetfulness, that's good enough for me. Praise God, my sins are gone. 'Twas at the old time altar where God came in my heart, and now my sins are gone. The Lord took full possession, the devil did depart. I'm glad my sins are gone. Well, they're underneath the blood on the cross of Calvary, as far removed as darkness is from dawn. In the sea of God's forgetfulness, that's good enough for me. Praise God, my sins are gone. When Satan comes to tempt me and tries to make me doubt, I say, my sins are gone. You got me into trouble, but Jesus got me out. I'm glad my sins are you glad? Well, they're underneath the blood on the cross of Calvary, as far removed as darkness is from dawn. In the sea of God's forgetfulness, that's good enough for me. Praise God, my sins are gone. Well, I'm living now for Jesus. I'm happy night and day because my sins are gone. My soul is filled with music. With all my heart I say, I know my sins are gone. Well, they're underneath the blood across the Calvary, as far removed as darkness is from dawn. Well, in the sea of God's forgetfulness, that's good enough for me. Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, praise God. Say it again. Hallelujah. Well, praise God. My sins are gone. Could you raise your hand and say, I'm glad my sins are under the blood of Jesus. Amen. That's the most precious thing in the world, to know that we know Him as our Savior. God is good to us. We're going to go before God in prayer this morning. We have some requests. We have Dave Besedich had surgery this week. Had surgery on one of the vertebrae in his neck. They had to go through the front. Some way they do that. But he's doing real good, and we thank God for that. Also, Onita, Sister Onita Baker, is in the hospital. Just seems like one of them gets out, the other one's in. Sid just got out of Ann Arbor, had surgery, and now they put her in yesterday for her heart, I believe. Where's Randy? Randy, was it her heart? She did have a reaction, I think, to some kind of medication or something last night, and was worse, and we want to remember her. Anyone on this side have a special request, real quick? Is pure than the snow, fresher than the breeze. He is lovely, her by. Just worship the Lord with us a minute. Hallelujah. Sing it with me. For He is fair than the lily of the valley. He is brighter than the morning star. He is pure than the snow, fresher than the breeze. Yes, my Lord is lovely, her by. Could you raise your hand and let's sing it to Jesus? Thank God. For He is fair. today were singing that song to Connie Travis. He was singing, "He is fairer than the lily of the valley." And then he come up to Connie and said, "Mommy, who is he? Who is he that's fair?" But I thank God for Jesus today, don't you? All the blessings he is to us. We're going to receive our offering before we turn the service back to Brother Louis this morning. And, you know, we mentioned last week that the first Sunday of every month we'd be receiving an offering to go toward our building fund. And I said, I hope we could get $500. Do you know how much we got last week? Right on the nose. I didn't put a penny in to make it either. I mean, I put some in. Don't get me wrong. I'm talking about to make it up to the 500. Amen. We got $500 right on the nose. And I think, let's give the Lord a hand for that. All right. Amen. Praise God. We're going to have the ushers come. Let's stand one more time as we receive this offering today. Amen. Praise God. Brother Randy, ask the blessing on the offering.
Let's put our hands together. We're going to celebrate Jesus' name. Let's put our hearts in motion. His precious word proclaim. Putting our past behind us and looking for the appointed day. Put our hands together now. Celebrate Jesus' name. Let's put our hands together. We're going to celebrate Jesus' name. Let's put our hearts in motion. His precious word proclaim. Putting our past behind us and looking for the appointed day. Put our hands together now. Celebrate Jesus' name. The smile upon his face here is such a sight. It's here for you and me. Oh, what a celebration. I feel his spirit here today. Put our hands together now. Celebrate Jesus' name. Let's put our hands together. We're going to celebrate Jesus' name. Let's put our hearts in motion. His precious word proclaim. Putting our past behind us and looking for the appointed day. Put our hands together now. Celebrate Jesus' name. Come one, come all to join us in this joyful way. You know that Jesus died to redeem us, and then he rose again on the third day. Open up your heart to him. His truth and everlasting song. Put our hands together now. Celebrate Jesus' love. Let's put our hands together. We're going to celebrate Jesus' name. Let's put our hearts in motion. His precious putting our past behind us and looking for the appointed day. Put our hands together now. Celebrate Jesus' name.
Amen. All right. Where's Louis? Did he leave us? Oh, here he is. I thought he'd run out on us. He had all the program. Thank the Lord that Louis is moving better. I don't say looking better. I said moving better. This is my son-in-law. If you don't know that.
Yes, I'm thankful that I'm moving much better, too. I appreciate the prayers and your cards that were sent. And we have some tributes for mothers, and we're so thankful for all of our moms. And we're going to be honoring all the mothers. We have some tributes that was wrote and penned and it, sent in, and they these people want to honor their mother this morning, and we're going to give these people a chance to do that. And we've got a special song or two that Sister Pam Shepherd will be singing for us in just a few moments. But I'd like to read a poem here. It's entitled God's Ideal Mother. And it goes like this. It says, "The toughest, most difficult job God ever assigned any individual is that of being a wife and a mother. To make clear what he expects of such a person, the Almighty has given us, Proverbs 31, a picture of an ideal mother. She has seven characteristics. One, she seeks always the good of her husband, therefore you can trust her. Two, she is industrious and therefore has no time to be a busybody. Three, she is constantly looking after the welfare of her family. Four, she has good judgment when it comes to financial well-being of her family. Five, she spends time in ministering to the needs of those outside her own family. Six, she is honorable, wise, and kind. Seven, she is one who firmly fears and reverences the Lord. Such a mother will be rewarded, for both her children and her husband will rise up and call her blessed. Mother, are you like this? And it asks, if not, why not? I thought if all of my mothers, our mothers, would line up to the scriptures and the instructions that God has given us, how much better off our nation would be. I thank God for the mothers that we have around here in this church. I look up to them and some of the Sunday school teachers that I sat under. I admired their lives that they lived in front of us. And I'm still watching your life and still being blessed by those. And Pam, if you'd like to get ready, we'll have her come to prepare that song. But there's a young lady who has wrote a tribute to her mother. And Sandra Ream, where are you, Sandra? She's downstairs getting ready. Okay. I'll read this tribute from Sandra's mom. It would be to Sandra's grandmother. And that mother is Barbara Bryant. And it was written by her daughter, Janie. It says, a mother to be proud of. Through the years, you might think that I never cared for the things that you have done for me, or listened to the encouraging or inspirational words you have said to me. But Mom, I have listened and I have cared. We had many a rough times, and for that I am sorry. But you never once gave up, and I thank you so very much, because if you wouldn't have prayed, that one last prayer, I wouldn't be the Christian woman I am today, honoring this special Mother's Day to you this May 9th, 1993. Mom, I want you to know that you are a mother to be proud of and that I love you. Happy Mother's Day. That's from Janie. Amen. Barbara, can you come and get this? I'm going to give you the poem and it's a bookmarker from the church. We want everybody to see who you are. This is a special mother, Barbara Bryant. This is Sister Pam Shepherd. She's got a song to honor the mothers. Standing
mercy was graceful, and now she lives in a total Christian home. This mother is more than just a mother of two. She's a mother to any child who at any given time just needs a mother's love. You see, this mother, in my opinion, is the greatest mother of all. You ask, who is this faithful, fine mother? Let me introduce her to you. Sister Newton, would you stand up? I call her my mom. I love my mother. Mom's having a real hard time with me getting ready to move out, getting married. But one thing I'm always going to know is that my mom loves God. She has stood by in times when people said it doesn't look good. But Mom, I thank you. And I love you.
Amen. Sister Newton, come get this poem. I think you deserve to have this. Give her this hand. A special mother.
Weighs
7 pounds. Her birthday is 4 minutes, and she's 4 years old. Her favorite food is chicken, and her favorite color is red. She likes to go to Chuck E. Cheese, and she enjoys skating, and that's Mackenzie's mom. Michaela Booth's mother. Where's Michaela Booth's mom? Where are you at, Sister Donna? She's standing in the back. This is Michaela Booth's mom. This is a story about Donna, my mom. Her hair is blonde, and her eyes are navy blue. She is 5 feet tall, and she weighs 5 pounds. Her birthday is in June, and she is 5 years old. Her favorite food is hamburgers. Her favorite color is yellow. She likes to go to Mimi's. She enjoys a good party. That's Michaela's mom. Another tribute that was written was by our pastor's wife. We're going to let her come now and read her tribute to her mother this morning.
First of all, I'd like to say Happy Mother's Day to their mothers, daughters, grandmothers, and their sisters. And special thanks to Sister Dana Wigginton and the Willem Workers for the nice mother and daughter banquet last night. We had a nice time at the old time kitchen in Taylor. Food was delicious. We had a nice time of fellowship. I thank the Lord for my children this morning, Connie, Keith, and Kim, and also Louie, Faye, and Kevin. I talked to Kim this morning. As you all know, she lives in Florida, and we both cried. And I'm not trying to honor myself today, but I want to read you her card. For my mother, because you do so much for me, I'm thankful for the things you are and for the things you've done to make my world a better place, my life a happier one. And I hope that you can understand how proud I'll always be to have a special mother who means so much to me. Dear Mom, this is the first Mother's Day that I haven't been with you. I know that me and Kevin are going to be sad Sunday. I miss you and wish that I could be there with you today and always. The reason that this card is empty is because I sent everything to Connie for your present. I can't wait to see you and Dad and everyone else in less than a month. I love you. Happy Mother's Day from Kim and Kevin. This is about my mother. About 3 weeks ago, our Sunday school superintendent, Brother Louis Philbeck, announced that anyone that would like to honor their mother would have the opportunity to do so in an essay or a letter. I thought, well, that's just for the kids, so I wasn't going to get involved. But I couldn't let this day go by, May the 9th, 1993, without giving honor to the most wonderful mother in the whole world, my mother, Virgil Grubbs. Dear mother, no one has ever been blessed more than I. God gave me you for a mother. Your sweet smile and gentle spirit has always been there for me, in the good times and in the bad. Your loving guidance and your words of wisdom have always been a blessing to our family. I remember when I was just a child, waking up in the night, afraid, asking you, will anything hurt me? You always assured me that nothing was going to hurt me, so I always went right back to sleep peacefully. I know it wasn't easy raising 5 children, but you always had time for all of us. You taught us to be honest and true and gave us a Christian home, a happy home. And you always loved our dad. You gave us the important things of life. You took us to the house of God and taught us to pray. Now that I have raised a family of my own, and I am also a great bread of idleness. And precious to me as the years go by, you are what love is all about. And the sunshine of my life, I will love you forever. Your daughter, Mary.
Thank you, Sister Cornelius. Now we have a tribute to a mother, to a special mother. And it goes like this. I don't have enough paper to say all the things I want to say about my mother, so I'll just try to say a few things. I'll start by saying she's the most beautiful person, both inside and out, that I have had the pleasure of knowing. Her face or her life story probably will never make the cover of People magazine, but these things will be embedded in my heart. She's not only my mom, but my very best friend. We can giggle like two schoolgirls, and we can cry together over serious matters as well. When I was growing up, I wasn't sure if she knew anything at all about important subjects, such as clothes, boys, and curfews. But now that I think back, it seems she knew everything about these things. She has been a Christian since she was around 12, and her values have carried throughout her early life into her adulthood. She and Dad raised two brothers and I in a wonderful Christian home where we went to church on Sundays, said grace before every meal, and feared God at every turn. She has such a loving and giving nature that there is nothing she won't do for anyone, day or night. I believe it has been her fervent prayers that has brought me through illness after illness, especially when I was in danger of liver failure, and it was through her prayers and loving touch that helped me through my recent surgery. One of her happiest moments was when she became a grandmother for the first time to my oldest child. Now that she's about to become a great-grandmother for the first time sometime this month, she is still the most beautiful person inside and out. She is, of course, my mother, Vida Lance. Vida, we want you and the lady that penned these words, Glenda, to stand. Vida, can you come get this poem? Another special mother. Okay, I have another one here that was handed to me this morning. And this was written by my oldest son. Where's Whitney Pruitt's Bible?